Question number five. Deals with what? CV, CP, and gamma for mono, di, and polyatomic. Guesses. Monoatomic, diatomic, and polyatomic gases. Notes band kar do. One full page. One full page. We want a relationship. First part is what? Para monoatomic gas. For a monoatomic gas, we'll perform this experiment. One. We take 1 mole of gas. 1 mole of gas. Number of moles? 1 mole. Supply some heat and increase the temperature from T to T plus delta T. Heat supplied by you, delta Q is equal to delta U plus work done. First law of thermodynamics. Pen down. Likhna nahi hai. Delta Q is equal to delta U plus delta W. There is no work done. Mechanical work done is zero. Whatever heat you are supplying, we call this as heat supplied at constant volume. Whatever heat you are supplying, that is used to increase its internal energy only, and the work done is zero. As per definition, CV is what? Amount of heat required to raise the temperature of 1 mole of gas by 1 degree C at constant volume. So, how many moles are there? 1. Value CV. If you increase the temperature by 1 degree C, but you are increasing the temperature by delta T. So, it is delta T is equal to delta U plus 0. CV is equal to delta U by delta T. This is one. And in this case, what is the increase in internal energy of the same? Increase in internal energy of the same is how many moles are there? 1 mole. How many atoms are there? Avogadro number, Na. Number is Na. It is a monoatomic gas. Total energy is 3/2 kT. Energy associated with the 1 degree of freedom is 1/2 kT. It is a monoatomic gas, ideal gas. So, energy associated with each atom is 3/2 kT. This is termed as energy, internal energy. Du by dt, differentiate both sides, or differentiate both sides with respect to T. Du by dt is equal to Na 3/2 k. Differentiation of T is what? Differentiation of T with respect to T is what? 1. So, what you get is Na 3/2 k. This Na, Avogadro number, K, Boltzmann constant. Boltzmann constant K is equal to R, capital R, gas constant, divided by Avogadro number. That means it is what? R by Avogadro number. Avogadro number cancel. What you get is 3/2 R. So, what I want to convey is du by dt, this is delta U by delta T, is equal to what? 3/2 R. R. So now onwards, when we say monoatomic gas CV is equal to 3 by 2 R, time with you is 3 minutes. You will use half of the page, half you will have to draw, because here I want to cover CP. 3 minutes to write. Why CV is equal to 3 by 2 R? This is the explanation. Now the same gas at constant pressure means open container. Say hypothetical cylinder, 1 atmospheric pressure, there is a gas, you supply heat, its a temperature increase again from T to T plus delta T dt. Let me mark it here. You supply heat, that is the first step, delta Q. If you supply this heat, then the piston moves to a new position. Piston has moved against constant pressure P. Whatever heat you have supplied, that is used for what purpose? Heat supplied by you is used to increase its internal energy plus some work done. In the previous part, at constant volume, piston was fixed. No movement of the piston, pressure cooker case. There was no mechanical work done, but here there is a mechanical work done. Because we are talking about what? This is at constant volume, this is at constant pressure. P is constant. This heat supplied will be same or more. Here some heat is required to increase the temperature only. Here the heat required is number one to increase the temperature plus for doing some mechanical work. Example, suppose you are supplying this heat 100 units, you are using 80 to increase its internal energy plus 20 for doing a mechanical work. As per definition, this delta QP is equal to what? CP is amount of heat required to raise the temperature of 1 mole by 1 degree C. 1 mole. The temperature increases by what? Delta T. Delta U is the same in the two cases. Why? Anyone? Internal energy is a point function, depends on initial and final temperature. So initial temperature was T, final is T plus delta T. Here also initial is T, final is T plus delta T. That is why delta U in the two cases remains the same. I can write it like this, 1 CV delta T plus work done. Mechanical work done is equal to pressure is constant P into dV or P into delta V. So if I divide it by delta T, what I get is CP is equal to CV plus P delta V by delta T. For any gas, PV is equal to nRT, correct? Gas equation, PV is equal to nRT. If you differentiate both sides, P is constant, N constant, R constant, I can write PdV is equal to nRdT. PdV by dT is equal to what? nR. N here is what? 1. So what I want to convey is PdV by dT. P dV by dt is equal to what? R. So what you get is CP is equal to CV plus R. per monoatomic gas, what was the value for Cv? 3 by 2 R. This is 3 by 2 R. This is R. When we solve Cp, Cp what you get is 5 by 2 R. So, Cv is 3 by 2 R, Cp is 5 by 2 R, and at the end you have to find out gamma. Gamma is equal to Cp by Cv is equal to what? 5 by 2 R divided by 3 by 2 R, what you get is 5 by 3. So, gamma is equal to 5 by 3 for monoatomic gas. Conclusion is, for monoatomic gas Cv is equal to what? 3 by 2 R. Cp is what? 5 by 2 R, and gamma is 5 by 3. Time with you is 4 minutes. We can write the conclusion in a tabular form. Monoatomic gas, Cv 3 by 2 R, Cp 5 by 2 R, gamma Cp by Cv 5 by 3. First part we have answered. B part, diatomic gas. See what is the change. Again, process at constant volume. I will give you time to take up the same. Heat supplied is used to increase the internal energy. Work done is zero. Everything is fine. Same. No change. Avogadro number into yes. For a diatomic gas, degrees of freedom, not 3. It is 5. 3 due to rotation and 3 due to translation and 2 due to rotation. So, what is 5 by 2? Here also you get 5. Here also you have 5. So, the result is what? 5 by 2 R. You will repeat this after some time. And the law for the same, at constant pressure, same process, everything same, no change. At the end you reach the same conclusion. Cp is equal to Cv plus R. Cv is what? Cv is 5 by 2 R. 5 by 2 R plus 1 R. 7 by 2 R. Gamma is Cp by Cv. 7 by 2 R divided by 5 by 2 R. 7 by 5. So that means for diatomic gas, Cv is what? 5 by 2 R. Cp is what? 7 by 2 R. And gamma? 7 by 5. 4 minutes with you. 5 minutes. Let's make it 5 minutes. C part, polyatomic gas. Suppose a gas has F degrees of freedom, F. then this value is what? F times 1 by 2 kT, because energy associated with each degree of freedom is 1 by 2 kT. So it is F. So this is also F. This is also F. So CV is equal to what? CV for that case is F by 2R. And if you mark it F, F by 2R plus R, CP is F by 2 plus 1 into R. What about gamma? Yes, gamma is CP divided by CV. F by 2 plus 1 divided by F by 2. What you get is gamma is equal to 1 plus 2 by F. Am I right? Yes. So you can write CV is equal to F by 2R, CP is equal to F by 2 plus 1R, and gamma is equal to what? 1 plus 2 by F. 3 minutes with you. You can simply write the conclusion only. CV is equal to F by 2R, CP is equal to F by 2 plus 1R, and gamma is equal to. Polyatomic means 3 atom, 4 atom, but we have only 3 atom as part of syllabus. So in case you have a polyatomic gas, how to find degrees of freedom? How to find F? That is what the question is. For monoatomic, degrees of freedom is 3. Polyatomic, sorry, diatomic, 5. So suppose you have a gas, 3 atoms, 2 possibilities are there. Formula for F is equal to 3 times A, where A represents number of atoms, minus R, where R represents relation. Through example, we will understand this. First part, it is a linear triatomic. Linear triatomic. 3 atoms. 1, 2, 3. A relationship. These dotted lines, a relationship. Degrees of freedom for this. F is equal to 3a minus relations. 3. Number of atoms, 3. Minus relations, 1 and 1, 2. So degrees of freedom is 7. Can you think of for a diatomic, this formula is applicable for a diatomic or not? Diatomic. How many atoms? 2 atoms. So for diatomic, A is 2. How many relations? 1. 3 into 2, 6 minus 1, 5. For monoatomic, single person, no relation. That is 3A. A is equal to 1. Relations is 0. So degrees of freedom is 3. It is true for monoatomic also. This is true for diatomic also. So you can assume that this formula is true for polyatomic also. Then you have 3 atoms arranged in this pattern. It's non-linear triatomic. Non-linear triatomic. Again, F is equal to what? 3A minus R. Number of atoms, 3. Relations, 1, 2, 3. 3 relations, 9 minus 3, 6. So very rare you have a question on triatomic, but in case you have a linear triatomic, degrees of freedom is F. Gamma, yes. What is the value for gamma for this? Gamma is equal to 1 plus 2 by F is equal to 1 plus 2 by 7 is equal to 9 by 7. For this case, gamma is equal to what? 1 plus 2 by F is equal to 1 plus 2 by 6 is equal to 1 plus 2 by 6 is what? 1 by 3 is equal to 4 by 3. We have all objective questions. You have objective question regarding linear triatomic degrees of freedom are 7. Value of gamma for this is 9 by 7. You have objective questions. For this also, you have objective question about degrees of freedom for non-linear triatomic. It is 6. And gamma for this is 4 by 3. Time with you is 4 minutes to write. Numerical number 15, 1, 5. Question is, calculate the number of degrees of freedom of molecules of hydrogen in 1 cc of hydrogen gas at NTP. Step 1, find number of degrees of freedom for one hydrogen molecule. Yes. Monoatomic or diatomic? So, how many degrees of freedom are there? 5. Why 5? 3 due to translational, 2 due to rotational. Step 1. Step 2. Number of degrees of freedom for 1 mole of hydrogen molecule, hydrogen gas. 1 mole has how many molecules? Avogadro number 6.023 into 10 to the power 23. 1 mole into 5. Step 3. 1 mole means what volume? 22.4 liters. When you say 1 mole, that means you say 22.4 liter of hydrogen has how many degrees of freedom? 6 into 10 to the power 23 into 5. 1 liter is how many cc? 1 liter water bottle is how many cc? 1000 cc. So, 22.4 liter. 1 liter is what? 1000 cc of hydrogen has how many degrees of freedom? 6 into 10 to the power 23 into 5. 1 cc of hydrogen will have how many? 6 into 10 to the power 3 into 5 divided by 22.4 into 1000. Solve an answer. 1 minute with you for calculation. First calculate, then after that you can write this. First have this part, calculation this part. This is 10 power 23, this is 10 power 3. 10 power 23 by 10 power 3 is 10 power 20. 6 into 5, 30 by 22.4. Because I know the answer, that is why I am writing, but you will have to find it. 1.34 into 10 power 20.